Hello students, today we are going to discuss one more essential Hadoop tool, that is Apache Oozie. It is also part of module 2. In the current IT world, Hadoop is an open source framework that is highly popular for its effectiveness and ease of use, basically in handling tasks related to big data analysis. As the big data analysis tasks require multiple jobs to be created in the process of analysis, it becomes essential to use an efficient process of job handling. That's where the Oozie comes in to picture, which is basically used to schedule the job efficiently or to handle it efficiently. So to define in a simple words what actually Oozie is, Apache Oozie is a scheduler system to run and manage especially Hadoop jobs, okay, run and manage Hadoop jobs in distributed environment. It allows multiple complex jobs to be run in a sequence order in order to achieve a bigger task. So this complex job can have a sub jobs which in turn can be run in a parallel way where there is a independency between the sub job or subtask. So Oozie is an open source Java web application available under Apache license 2.0. That's why it is called Apache Oozie. So Oozie is a workflow directed system designed to run and manage multiple related Apache Hadoop jobs. Okay, multiple related Apache jobs. So its main aim is to make the workflow simpler and coordination between the multiple jobs convenient. So when I say workflow, it is nothing but it is a sequence of tasks or a job. Say for example, I want to send the data from external Hive file to a ORC Hive file. I want to transfer the data from external Hive file to a ORC Hive file. So what is the sequence I have to do? First, I have to create a table in Hive. Then I have to insert the values into the Hive. Similarly, the same property tables I have to create in the ORC Hive file. Okay. Then I have to perform the transfer. I have to call the I have to write a code in order to transfer the data between these two. So these are the tasks included involved in the transferring the data from the external Hive file to a ORC Hive file. So job is here is the creating the table. Another job is to inserting the value. Inserting the value into the table, okay, and another job is to create a similar table in a ORC Hive, okay, then transfer data transfer. These are the tasks. So here when I say workflow, so in the which sequence or in what sequence this task has to be done, okay, is nothing but the workflow, okay. So here where the Oozie will be helping the Hadoop system. So here this diagram or the picture shows where actually the Oozie is placed in the Hadoop ecosystem. Okay, so Oozie can drive core Hadoop components like MapReduce jobs and STFC operations, file operations. Okay, in addition to this, it also can orchestrate most of the common high level tools such as Pig, Hive, Scoop, okay, DiscCP, like that. And more importantly, Oozie can be extended to support any custom Hadoop job written in any language. Although it is primarily designed to handle Hadoop components, Oozie can also manage the execution of any other non-Hadoop jobs such as Java class or shell script and so on. Okay, So we move on to in detail, we see what actually OSI workflow is all about. So OSI workflow jobs are represented as a directed acyclic graph. Okay, in short, we call it as a DAG. Okay, it is a DAG of actions or directed acyclic graph of actions. So here there will be a set of actions or jobs, and the interdependency between the jobs will be there in this graph. Okay, so here directed acyclic graph is an inbuilt process in the OSI structure that is used by the program to define the actions. I tell you what are the actions in the next slide. In the DAG process of OSI, the acyclic term means no loop. Okay, there is no loop. So the action graph has a separate start point and the end point. There is no cycle there. Okay. So here, basically, there are three types of jobs are permitted. One is workflow, second one is coordinator, and the third one is bundler. What is this workflow? It is a specified sequence of Hadoop jobs with outcome-based decision points and control dependency. So it will be having actions. Okay, there will be a set of action nodes. I'll tell you in the coming slides with an example. Okay, it will show in what sequence the job has to be executed to achieve the complex job. That is actually a workflow. So coordinator. Coordinator means it will be it will be running the scheduled workflow job. Okay, at various time interval or when the data is available. That is coordinator. Bundle means it is like a package which will be batches the or which will be bundling the set of coordinator jobs. So at the high level, bundle is there. Below that, coordinator will be there, and below that, at the lower level, the workflow will be there. So this diagram which I am showing in the next slide, that is this slide, is depicting that. So if you see here at the layer 3, at the lower level, we have a set of actions. When I say set of actions, it is nothing but Hadoop jobs only. So MapReduce is Hadoop job, Pig is a Hadoop job, file system is a Hadoop job, okay? Hadoop file system, HDFS is a Hadoop job. So we have a set of actions which are actually Hadoop jobs. Okay, this jobs is running in some sequence. So when this job is over, then there can be two other jobs which can be run in parallel. So they are not interdependent to each other. They can, the output of this action is an input for this two. So this two can be run independently. So this can be run using this output as an input. Okay, this can be run independently. So whereas to run the another next map reduce job, the output of this two is required. So it has to be merged. So Pig job, it is merged and it is taken, the output of this two is merged and it has taken as an input for the another map reduce job. And again, this output is taken as an input to the another job or action, the Pig job. So this we called as a workflow. Okay, this is defined as a workflow, which is nothing but a set of actions. Okay, so this job is coordinated by a coordinator when this data is available or a particular time interval. Okay, this coordinator and the set of coordinators is bunched as one bundle. That is a bundle. Bundle is usually an optional one. Okay, so next we move on to workflow definition. The workflow process, as I told in the previous slide, the workflow process in the OSI is a collection of different action types, including MapReduce job or Pig jobs, okay, so on, which are arranged based on the directed acyclic graph, which in short we called as a DAG, which defines the sequence for the different action to execute. The DAG graph is defined in the specific language called HPDL, that is XML Process Definition Language. Okay, what is this HPDL? HPDL is a very compact language and makes use of minimal amount of action nodes and flow control nodes. In this language, the control nodes are used to specify the execution flow for different action, like starting, ending, failure, like that, and allows the instruction set to define the execution path by the help of node like decision node or fork node and join node. So that we are going to study in detail in this, okay, in this part. Okay, different types of nodes. So here, so what is this action nodes? All this we called as a different types of nodes. So we have basically two nodes which will be most of the time used, that is control flow nodes and the action nodes. So control flow nodes are nothing but it defines the beginning and end of the workflow by using a node name as start, end, in case of error it is kill. So action nodes are nothing but it is an instruction or the instruction that function as necessary triggers that initiate the execution of action when the necessary conditions are met. Okay, here action nodes actually process the task, okay, that are defined, and also it includes the SDFS commands. Then we have a fork node and join node and the decision node. Fork node is used when say for example I show you here in this diagram, say for example I told as told before, so this node, actually this is an action node. Once this node is completed its task, okay, so once one job is completed, then only the next job will be taken in the workflow. So once this job is completed, this output will be taken for the parallelly two other action nodes can be run, like pick job and file system job can be run parallelly. So in that case we have to use the action node called fork here. So fork can be used here. And here whenever we want to join or merge the output of two action node as a one, then we can go for a node called action node called join. Okay, join. So that is about the fork and the join. So fork and join always work together. So whenever we want to go for parallel execution, you can go for fork. Then whenever we want to merge, you can go for join. Okay, so decision node. Decision node means to proceed further or not. Okay, to proceed further or not, you have to take a decision. Okay, so based on some values. So in that case, you can go for a decision, true or false. Okay, true or false. So enable decision to be made about previous task. So based on the true means you can proceed, or false means you can end it there itself. Okay, like that. So in that cases you can go for the decision node. To illustrate all this node, let us take as one example of workflow which is complex in nature. So let us take this example, complex OSI workflow. So we have a control nodes like start, end, okay, in case of error there will be kill control node also, and there are set of action nodes. This is action node, whatever, whichever is in the rectangular shape, okay, rectangular shape, they are called the action nodes, and the round action nodes, okay, and which are in the round shape or oval shape we called as a control nodes. Here two control nodes are the start and end. If you observe here, there is no cycle here, so that's why we called as a workflow as a DAG, directed acyclic graph. Okay, so here we started with the job, so file system job, where like a make directory, okay, creating the directory. If the directory is created, then the action called as fork is then where which will be executing two different jobs parallelly, that is map reduce streaming job and the pick job. When both are completed, okay, then the output of this task will be merged, okay, by the join action node. Okay, then it will be passed to a decision node. So decision node will take if it is okay, it can proceed, then it will go to another action node called Java. There is still input is required, or still it's not enough, more is required. Okay, MapReduce string is not, still more expectation is there, then it will go to the case when it is MapReduce Java. Once it is okay, then it will come to an action node called Java action. So once this job action is completed, once this job is completed, okay, then it will, once it is completed completely, that is, it's okay, then it will move on to the another action, another job called file system job, okay, which is the change mode. Okay, then the finally, once the task is completed, then it is nothing but the end one. Okay, so this is one of the complex OOSI workflow, which is showing the control nodes and the action nodes, okay, along with the fork, join, and the decision node. So let us take one simple example of OOSI to in work or to discuss in detail about the workflow. Okay, so here let us consider a simple example of OOSI. So here this example depicts you that we have a control node like start, end, and kill. So start means it will start the process, okay, and the control has gone to a MapReduce action node. This is the action node which is performing the MapReduce task. That is, it is finding a word count. It is finding the words, a number of occurrences of words or frequencies of words in a given set of documents. Okay, so this already we have discussed in the class, what is MapReduce word count program. Okay, with an example we have discussed already. So I'll show you once again for just to recall. So please understand, here there is an action node called MapReduce word count. So if the word count is all the words are counted and the successfully executed, then it will have the flow that okay, once the action is completely executed, the whole job is executed completely successfully, then it will move to a end control node called end, that is, job is completed. But in middle it come across some error or the disturbance, then it will move on to a control that is kill. That means the job will be completely killed or erased. That means either it has to happen or it should not happen. There is no a partial thing. So once it is not able to complete, then it is a error. That means the kill action will be taken. That means it will be completely taken out, it will not be executed further. So this helps in failover purpose and all. So this is, so once the MapReduce count, the action node is completed, the workflow will be generated in the form of a XML as